Nearly all of the information you consume each day has gone through a written phase at one point or another. Some information stays in written form, like books, while other information eventually changes forms, like lyrics being recorded as a song, or script being filmed and turned into a movie. Writing used to be all done by hand. It's true. But people got tired of their wrists hurting all the time, so they invented typewriters. Typewriters. Because you could write on the paper by typing on the keys. Get it? Some people still use typewriters today, but they're pretty rare. The only typewriters I've ever actually seen in real life were in museums, and that one in my great-grandma's attic. Technology has evolved a lot since the days of typewriters, but it really hasn't changed that much. We still type on keys, the writing appears on the computer monitor, and then we can send it to a printer to print out on paper. Computers do have one thing that typewriters didn't: word processing software, which can be used to enhance your writing in ways my great-grandma could never dream of. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use the basic features of word processing software to format text. Let's get into it. In this video, my friend B will demonstrate the different features of word processing software using Google Docs, which is a particular word processing app that you can access for free by logging into a Google account. If you have a different word processor you'd like to use, that's fine too. You can still follow along. The features will mostly be the same, but the icons might look different or be located in a different place. All right, B, you're up.
Hello there, this is Bee. I'm so excited to show you all the things you can do with word processing software. When you first open your word processor, you'll see a screen similar to this. Near the top, you'll find your menu bar, including the file menu that you learned about in the previous lesson. Underneath the menu bar, you'll find a toolbar. If you're on Google Docs, like me, you'll notice the document title as well. Since we haven't named it anything yet, it's currently named Untitled Document. To change it, we simply click on the title and then type in our new name. I'll name mine Word Processing Software. If you're using a different word processor, you might have to open the File menu and save your document in order to give it a title. This small line right here is where your text will be inserted as you type. If you're currently following along on a word processor, go ahead and type whatever you want now. I'm just going to write my document's title here. Word Processing Software. Now that we have some text on the page, we can start formatting it. Most of the formatting options you'll need can be found on the toolbar. All you have to do is highlight the text you would like to change. Then select what you would like to do to it using the toolbar. If I want to change the font, I can click this drop-down and select a different font. Mia's favorite font is ABZ, so I'm going to choose that one. Look at all the different fonts you can choose. The font size option is usually right next to the font. If I highlight the text I want to make bigger or smaller, I can press the plus sign to make the text bigger, the minus sign to make it smaller, or click the number itself to choose a size. I'm going to make my text size 24, so it's larger and easier to read. The next section of the toolbar is used to make sections of your text stand out more. The B stands for bold. Can you tell what's different about one of the words on my screen? I've bolded the word processing, causing it to look thicker and darker than the other words. The I stands for italics. Notice how the word processing looks a little more slanted than the other words? The U stands for underline, and it's pretty easy to see why when you look at how the word processing has changed this time. It has a line under it. Each of these three options, bold, italics, and underline, can be used to add some extra emphasis to specific words or phrases. You can also color your text. Look at all those colors! I can make my text red, or blue, or even white. But for now, I'll leave it black, since that will be easiest for you to see against the white background. You can also change the color around the text, which is known as highlighting. You can typically choose the same colors to highlight with that you can choose for the text color. But be careful, if you make your text and highlight the same color, the text will be totally unreadable. We're going to skip over the next section on the toolbar, but don't worry, those tools will be covered in the next lesson. The Align tool can be used to change how text is aligned on the page. The default is left aligned, meaning the text lines up along the left side. You can also choose center alignment, which makes each line of text move to the exact middle of the page. Right align lines up each line of text along the right side of the page. And justified alignment? Well, let me show you this way. If you read a lot of books, justified alignment will look familiar. Each line of text is automatically aligned to both the left and right sides, which sometimes requires the text to be spaced out a little more to make it fit. The next tool controls the amount of space between your lines and paragraphs. Mine is currently set to 1.15. If I change it to single spacing, it reduces the amount of space between lines. I can also choose 1.5 spacing or double spacing, which is often used in professional and academic documents. There are more options here, but those are more advanced, so we won't worry about them for now. We're going to skip over the next three tools. They're a little more advanced, so we'll cover them in the next lesson. These next two tools change the indentation of your text. The one with the arrow pointing to the right indents your entire paragraph further to the right, and the one with an arrow pointing left moves your paragraph back towards the left. Before we check out this last tool, let's have a little fun. Pause this video and use the tools we have already learned about to format your example text in the weirdest, wildest way you can. Pause now. Here's how mine ended up. And now, it's time to undo all of that. The final tool clears formatting. Just highlight the text and select the Clear Formatting tool. And your formatting resets to the defaults, even font and font size. Keep practicing with all of the tools you've learned today, and you'll be a pro like me in no time.
I hope you learned a lot from Bea about the basic tools you can use with word processing software. But that's not all word processors can do. In the next lesson, we'll learn about some of the more advanced features of word processing software, like the ability to create tables, link to websites, and even insert pictures. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.